Hello everyone, I have a question. How often do you hear this phrase in the bowling environment?
That ball rolls like a sausage on roller skates.
Okay, never. We never hear that phrase. But how about this one? We do hear that a lot, but do we change the surface enough to produce any real difference? Or is it just a misconception? Coming up after some cool photons hit the ball. I will be using a new Abalone 4000 and a new TrueCut 5000D. And if these two create very little difference, then any used pad will create even less or none at all. Now, to eliminate the cover stock factor, I will use them both on the same ball. And luckily, fate provided, and one of my personal balls cracked in half in 2020. So, yay, we have a ball to test now. I'm going to do the method by hand and use dry pads, because first, I think most people do it with dry pads. And secondly, if dry pads do not create much difference, then wet pads would create even less or, again, none at all. Now, because everybody does a little bit differently the sanding of the ball by hand, I will try to not exaggerate in anything. I will just use average pressure. And from what I've seen and what I know, most people will not spend more than 15 seconds per side of the ball. So I'm going to use one of the pads for 15 seconds on this side and one on this side. And then we're going to check results and see what we're actually doing. So I polished this ball. I don't know if you can see it, but it's very shiny. It's around 5,400, which is basically the polish you get from the factory. When you get a bowling ball and it says 1500 polish, that's usually between 5000 and 5500, and most of the times it's around 5300, 5400. So I recreated that one for our test. Of course, I'm going to scan the ball again so you can see that it's actually 5400. And because now we're going to start the experiment, I'm not going to have any editing from now on, so I'm going to mess up my talking, so sorry about that. Okay, let's rescan this for you. And I don't know if you can see it, but yeah, you can see it. It's 5,400, maybe a bit more. So, because I don't want to mess with one part while I'm doing the other part, I'm going to put some tape right here. So that way we don't mess with that one, with that part of the ball. Of course, it's never, when you put tape, it never goes straight. And the ball is not exactly split in half. So, bear with me. Okay. Okay, so let's try to do above the fingers with the true cut and below with the abalone. Let me fix this one a little bit. Okay. So let's try the true cuts over here. Here it is, unused. Seconds, okay? Not too much pressure. Here we go. There's a tiny bit, very little dust, almost nothing. Okay, we flip it over here and let's do the abalone. Unused. Again, that's not much to see here. Okay. No, let's scan that it is. Actually, okay. So let's check the area that we used the true cut, which is this one. I don't know if you can see it. I will try to show it on the computer later. It's this part. And as I turn the ball, the grit is 5,400, 5,000, 4,700, it's a little bit lower over here. So between 4,600 and 5,000. Now let's check the other area, this one, that we did the abalone. Okay, so here we have 5,400, 5,300, 55, 5,000, 4,800, 46, 5,000. Mostly between 4,800 and 5,000. So a little bit lower with the true cut and a little bit higher with the abalone. To me, if the ball from 5,400 went to around 5,000 or 4,800, I don't think you're going to see much difference. It's going to be so minimal that it's whatever difference you see, it's probably going to be due to some other factor. The release, your speed, the lane, something else. Differences between 4,800 and 5,300 or 5,400, I don't think they're very noticeable, maybe not at all. And even visually, when I see the ball, I don't see the shine being removed. Of course, the factory polish maybe is a little bit shinier or has some of that polish still on the ball, while this one may not have it. But still, I'm just judging it from the point of view of the scanner. So here, let me do something else. Let me do another 50 seconds for both sides. And so we have a total of 30 seconds and see if that makes any difference. Okay. This side was the one with the true cuts. I'm gonna do another 15 seconds, okay? Again, you don't see anything on the, hardly anything on the pad. And let's do the abalone over here, making sure I get all of the surface. I'm wiping the ball, but I'm not actually seeing anything to wipe. So the okay. All right. Now let's check the area of the true cut, which is over here. 4900, 48, 44, 47, 46, 43. Then it's a little bit over here, it's a little bit at 5300, 52, and then we hit the tape. Okay, so about the same as before, actually. And now let's see the abalone side, which is over here. We have 5300, 52, 51, 50. 5,000, 4,900, 48, 46, 47, 49, 48, 49. This is mostly the same. It's about between 4,800 and 5,000 or 5,100, around there. These two parts are the caused by the tape. Okay, so we did 30 seconds for each side, which may be a little bit more than most people do. Yet, on the other hand, maybe some people just keep on sanding the ball until they visually see some difference. I don't know. But most of them claim that they just touch it up a little bit, so I didn't do anything harsh on the ball. And at least with these, with new pads, and with both of them, we saw a little bit, a drop, a bit of a more of a drop with the true cut. So this one went from 5400, this side went from 5400 to 48, 4900, 5000, 4600. So let's say that it's on a range between 4500 and 5000 for the true cut. And for the abalone, we went from 5400 again to between 4800 and 5000. That's the result we got. So now I'm no expert because I haven't thrown two balls after this method, and because our bowling centers are still closed. But I doubt that the difference will be visible to the eye. And I also think that, as I said before, any difference we see, because we're not robots, we can't throw two exactly same shots. Any difference we're going to see is more likely to be caused by some other little thing that we changed in our shot than the difference of 5,400 to 5,000 or to 4,900 or 48. Basically, because, for example, lane sign is around 4,700. So all balls end up around that number. And then if you have two identical balls and they lane sign, they will, of course, react the same way. Anyway, I hope this adds a little bit info in this cracking of the sign thing. And if you have any comments about how to do this experiment even better, or a different version of it, or some other method of cracking the sign that that I don't know about, maybe I can test that too. Thanks for watching. If you liked it, subscribe, like, and share the video with everyone. Thanks.